Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And today Apple released iOS 13.4.5, which is kind of strange. They have done this before back, I believe in iOS 10 or 11 days. And this one came in at 4.11 gigabytes. Now, anytime you go from a public release to a beta or from a beta back to a public release, it has to install the full OS. That's why it's over 4 gigabytes. And it was over 3 gigabytes on all of these other devices, the iPad Air 2, the iPhone XR, and the iPhone 6S Plus. Now, Apple also released iPadOS 13.4.5, tvOS 13.4.5, and also macOS Catalina 10.15.5 betas. Those three are all in beta. And so let's take a look at the build number and then we'll talk about what's new. The build number is 17F5034C. And this particular build does have a couple new features in it, or new changes anyway, but there is not anything new in the notes. However, there is a new modem update. Now, I wasn't having any issues with LTE or Wi-Fi. However, a few people were with 13.4, specifically Wi-Fi, they were having a few issues with. Whether or not this fixes that is hard to say, and will take a few days to know for sure. But either way, it has been updated. Now, the first thing I would think that this fixes is the VPN issue that some people were having. And what I mean by that is there's a bug in 13.4 that Apple acknowledged that when you turn on a VPN connection, if you're using a third-party VPN or not, what can happen is that information may or may not be encrypted. It's supposed to be encrypted at all times. When you're using a VPN, a virtual private network, that's kind of the point. And so sometimes it wasn't encrypted. So hopefully this fixes it, although they haven't mentioned anything in the notes whatsoever. Now, aside from that VPN bug that hopefully is fixed, they've also fixed the 3D press or haptic press to open Bluetooth. So if you don't have settings open in the background and you 3D press or haptic press on settings and tap on Bluetooth, it no longer crashes. So that's fixed in this update. Also, some people were having issues with battery or the phone heating up in mail, and none of those things that I'm aware of are fixed, at least that they've mentioned, but that doesn't mean they haven't fixed them. But there is definitely still a bug with mail and it checking for mail on its own. So that's still going on. Why they haven't fixed that yet, I'm not sure, but that's what seems to be the focus of this, is bug fixes. Now, one of the new things that's in this is if we go into music and then pick a song here, and then we go to share the song. So we'll go in and share the song. We now have the option for sharing it to Instagram, and it will create a story. And then we can open it in Instagram and post a story. So it will actually create it on its own. We can post it to Facebook as well. And so that's a nice little feature if you share those things to Instagram or Facebook often. It just saves you a step or two. Now, one thing that you can't see is that if you use the activity app, you have a bunch of different awards. Within this beta, Apple has actually added all of the new 2021 exercise award images for each month of 2021. So you can't see those right now. I haven't found any place in here, but it's actually in the code that these awards are currently there for 2021. So they're getting things ready ahead of time, and it looks like the activity app is updated with that. Now, also, there's some slight changes with Apple Watch text. So this is not a huge change by any means, but let's go into the Watch app. And under the Watch app, under Express Transit Card, there's some new text there. It's nothing big, but they've just made some changes with the Express Transit Card, and some notifications can let you know if the card balances are low and things. And that's throughout this OS. There's little tiny tweaks to different wording and verbiage throughout. And I found that thanks to Steve Mosier, my friend from MacRumors. And so if you haven't followed him on Twitter yet, be sure to do that. He has a lot of good information. Now, also in the code is mention of a new phone with Touch ID. So that sort of lines up with what we might see as far as an iPhone 9 or 9 Plus coming a little bit later in April. Now, as far as any features or bug fixes or anything we're aware of, currently right now, that's it. There may be some future fixes in there that I notice within the next couple of days. And if there is, I'll let you know if there's anything different. But there is some other things that Apple did today. And the first one is they bought the Dark Sky Weather app. So they've bought this. You can see it now says Apple under the developer name or owner. So they've bought this app. Whether or not they're going to incorporate it into weather, maybe in iOS 14 or something along those lines, is hard to say, but maybe they'll switch over to something like that, or there's something in there they needed as far as a patent. It's hard to say, but they did buy it, and it still does cost $4 in the United States. They also updated Pages, Keynote, and Numbers on the Mac. So if you use Pages, Keynote, or Numbers, they've added some features with iCloud folder sharing and things like that. So there should be feature updates all around for that in particular. Now, as far as battery life, well, battery life is hard to judge on the first day. It's only been an hour or two since it's been out, but my battery health is at 100%. So that gives us a baseline as far as what the battery health is and the overall battery usage. And on 13.4, it's been pretty decent at 3 hours and 6 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 12 minutes of screen off time, and under 50% usage. And generally, I tell people 10 to 12 hours of screen on time. And most people have been saying they've been getting good battery life with 13.4. There are a few people that are saying that they are not, and whether or not that's app related, specific to whatever apps they're using, it's hard to say. But hopefully this just fixes any of those little bugs that might decrease battery at all. Now, as far as overall performance, well, on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, it's been pretty good. However, it did lock up on me already in music. I haven't had settings lock up like it did on 13.4, but it did lock up in music briefly, maybe for 1 to 2 seconds when I was trying to go through there. And you might have just seen some frame rate drop. So I do record these videos at 60 frames per second, so you can see that if there is a frame rate drop. Now, it is an early beta, so there definitely could be some tweaks by the end and by the time it's released. But on older devices, such as this iPhone 6S Plus, you should expect basically the same performance. This is not a major change. This is more of a bug fix, security patches, and things like that. So again, on this, on the iPhone XR, all of these devices are going to get the same features and they're going to get the same performance as they had before until Apple actually updates that. You'll see on the XR, it seems the smoothest of any of them, or at least so far it does. And just swiping seems pretty good, and going into new apps and things for the first time seem okay. But that doesn't mean, again, that this is finished software, so it could change over time. As far as iPadOS 13.4.5, well, there's nothing really new in that other than what I've already mentioned. And again, on the oldest iPad here, the iPad Air 2, expect performance to be basically the same. I would not expect anything different. We'll go into music for the first time on here. You'll see it's a little bit slow at first, but then it kind of speeds up. So that's kind of what I expect on the iPad. Now let's take a look at the benchmarks. Now these could change over time and as things happen in the background as far as background processes, but I did run Geekbench 5 on all of them. And on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,332 for single core, 3,392 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, take a look at CPU. You'll see the scores are a little bit higher on this beta than they were on iOS 13.4 when I installed it. Both single core and multi-core are a little bit higher. Not a ton, but a little bit. Now let's take a look at all of these devices so you can compare what you have with what I have here. On the left, we have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So here are the general scores that your devices should get somewhere around these numbers. Probably not exactly the same, but very close. And as long as they're close, you should have the same performance as I do. That's it for iOS 13.4.5 beta 1, and expect the public beta either later today or maybe tomorrow. Depends on when they're going to release it. It's really hard to say. It could be out by the time you're watching this video. Now, as far as 13.4.1 or anything else like that, Apple could release those, but usually they don't do that. So expect them to skip a few updates, I guess, and then release this one to the public. But at this point, it's really hard to say what Apple's going to do for sure. There was information earlier today that 13.4.1 would be coming out to the public. And so maybe it still will to fix the VPN issue. Maybe it won't. It's hard to say, but if it does, I'll keep you updated with that as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.